Fox Talks with the stars of your favorite shows.
We don't have a lot of time to improv. You know, we shoot about between 25 and 32 pages in a 5-day period. So we stick pretty closely to the script. The scripts have been worked on really hard. We get them really well in advance. So the writers are working on them well after we've done our table read and making any rewrites that they need to make. And so we trust them to do their job, which they do so fantastically well. And then they turn it over to us, and you know, we do our best to serve what they've written. And as far as improv goes, I'm not sure any of us could come up. We come up with little things here and there, behavioral things we'll come up with all the time. But in terms of dialogue or jokes and stuff like that, they're the experts. It was not fun. It was very thick, you know, like dry paint. It looked hilarious. You know, anything for a joke. I will do anything for a joke. I don't think so. It's never been mentioned to me. Although I know that it was a well-received episode and I was delighted by it. I was thrilled with how it came out. Well, the 52nd Street Project is a group that's been around for about 25 years and they help kids in the Hell's Kitchen neighborhood of Manhattan learn how to make their own plays. And so they pair them with theater professionals like myself or other actors or other playwrights or directors. And they write their own plays and then perform in them with their professional partner. And it is the most exciting, most challenging work I've ever had to do acting in a play written by an 8-year-old. You cannot imagine. But if you're ever in New York, the shows are always free. You can look up their schedule on 52project.org. And they're an awesome organization. I love working with them and have for years. I just might. I don't have any plans. I'm going to be working on my birthday, which is, you know, very fortunate. I always consider myself lucky when I'm working on my birthday.